So when you're first starting to learn how to use Blender, there is a lot to pick up. So today I'm going to show you 10 quick tricks to make your learning experience just a little bit easier. So for the first couple of tips, let's go ahead and jump into Edit and Preferences and change a couple settings. If you're on a laptop, I highly recommend using Emulate NumberPad. Emulating the NumberPad allows you to access quick rotation snaps with the press of one button. So press one for a front view, three for a side view, seven for a top, and nine for bottom. So let's go back into our preferences and go to System, and under Memory and Limits, increase our undo steps to as high as you can go. If your computer has a high enough RAM, I would recommend going to the highest limit, 256. If not, at least bring it to 100 so you can save yourself the pain of having to scrap a project because you made too many mistakes and you couldn't go back and fix them. So the next setting I highly recommend using is changing how your camera rotates around an object. So go to Navigation and click Orbit Around Selection. Click Save, and then whatever object you select, the camera will now rotate around. This makes modeling fine details around an object a lot easier. Your model will stay in the center. Here we can go boom, click F to focus, and you can rotate around the object with ease. So as you begin working with larger scenes, you may need to scale multiple objects at the same time. By doing that, you can select a group, press S. By default, it scales around a bounding box. So it's creating an invisible box around this group and scaling along the center of that. If you want to change it to scale around the object's origin, go ahead up here, click this box, and then click Individual Origins. And as you can see, now our objects are scaling around each object's origin. Blender's default shading settings are a little tricky to read sometimes. You can see that oftentimes extrusions get blended together, and personally, when I'm modeling, I want the edges to be emphasized a little more. So, in order to change that, we can go into our shading settings and turn on cavity. And you can see the difference is pretty huge. This just makes the shape a little easier to read as you're working on it. Finding the perfect camera angle for your scene can be really tricky using the traditional transform operations. I highly recommend using the zero key to snap your camera into your viewport. Press the N to access the sidebar. Go to the third box down under View and click on Camera to View. That allows you to control the camera within your viewport. You can manipulate the object's origin to make snapping a lot easier. So let's say we wanted to snap this cube to the ground. All we have to do is hold the shift key and right click on the bottom. Go ahead and right click on the object, set origin, and origin to 3D cursor. You can see that the orange dot has moved from the middle to the bottom. All we have to do now is make sure that our object's still selected. Go ahead and shift and click on the plane. Go to snap and press selection to active. And you can see that our cube is now attached to the surface of the plane. So something that I find really helpful is changing the way my viewport looks. In Blender, you have full customization. All you have to do is drag your mouse to the edge of your viewport, right click, press vertical split or horizontal split, drag that line to wherever you want it to go, click, and you can see that we have two boxes now. You can change this first viewport to whatever you need it to be, UV editor maybe. If you're animating, you can change it to your timeline. And if you ever want to undo that and go back to your default layout, bring your mouse to the corner and drag it to the other box. And then you've returned to your original layout. So whenever you're modeling, it's very important to use a reference. So in order to do that, first I recommend snapping your camera to front view by pressing one. Press Shift A. go to image, and then reference. Once you press that, you'll get the file browser. Find whatever image you want to use as your reference. Let's say you're using some blueprints. Open that up, and there you go. You have your blueprints. Something that's helpful is to jump to this icon, click that, and you can adjust the opacity with the slider. A really great resource for finding and gathering your references is called PureRef. It's an app that lets you create a quick board to gather a bunch of images so you have something to reference while working on a model. So let's say you're working on a spaceship and you want to gather a bunch of different images. All you have to do is open a website like Pinterest, click on an image. Once you find something you like, drag it into your reference board, and you can start collecting. Grab whatever images you need, and then you can organize them in whatever way you like. An operation you'll end up using all the time is Shade Smooth. Click on your object, then right click, press Shade Smooth, and you can see that we have a shading error. To fix that, go to this green icon, Object Data Properties, click Normals, and then press the Auto Smooth checkbox. From here, by default, it is set to 30, which is perfect for a cylinder. So those are the 10 tips that I think every beginner should know. As you continue your learning journey, I highly recommend just being very experimental. If you don't know what something means, look it up or hover over it, and you can see that a little tooltip will pop up and explain to you what that setting is doing. If you don't understand it from there, just experiment and start adjusting numbers or, you know, clicking boxes and see what happens. That's the best way to learn. And slowly but surely, you begin to pick up a ton of different tricks. And after a while, you'll just become very comfortable with Blender and what everything means. And I think it's a pretty good feeling. So keep at it, and you'll be surprised by how much progress you can make in just a few weeks. Thanks for watching, guys.